Hello guys, DB Grinder here, back at it again with another video, and this time it's Scraps with 148 rating versus Rosen 316 with 157 rating. I just wanted to say, like, the rating doesn't really matter, it's the beginning of the format. I mean, I have like 200 rating, but I'm a pretty good player, it's just the beginning of the format, it's like 3 days in. But Scraps is going to win the Rock, Paper, Scissors, Shoot. And he's going to choose to go first. Also, I have the silent mouse. So I'm clicking right now. You guys might be able to barely hear that because I'm spamming it. But it's silent. The opening hand is Faker, Veiler, Duality, Crackdown, Faker. It's pretty good. He opened the trap plus Faker and a hand trap. And then his opponent opened up Area Zero, Widow, Cosmic, Upstart, Ash. So that hand's not terrible. I mean, he doesn't have a way to ray up. Duality gets Ash. I completely agree with that. People used to call me stupid for when people would activate Duality and I'd Ash it. Well, it's like you could get a trap off of that, and then trap stops the way to ray. Game. Also, there's not too many cards to Ash. Like, they can't activate Extravagance after Duality. Odds are that Duality was like the one search they were doing that turn. Set Crackdown, pass, Jarl's Nib. That's not going to be too good versus this matchup, unless if he's going for like the access code talker play. Cosmic on the set. I'm doing some wacky plays in my Geist deck. I don't play access code talker, but I do like the Mechum Phantom Beast Link plays. Like, differently than you would expect. Nah, it's nuts. Upstart, draw desires. And then activate desires. Draw Shark Cannon and an Imperm. So still doesn't have Ray. He banished two Rose and Ray. Activates Area Zero, set Shark. Zero. Gets him Widow, so he still doesn't have a way to ray. He could have grabbed Afterburners there. Instead of a Widow. Knowing that, like, Geist, you only really need, like, one monster negate. I mean, he also has Imperm. And then if he, like, summons out Marionetter and sets Protocol, he could Afterburners pop Marionetter and pop Area Zero to get started. Draws Mel, you see, not what he wanted to draw, it's not a trap. Normal summon, then battle phase, attack for 500. Widow Anchor, to steal. And then end phase, he gets it back. Draws another Nib. Again, it's not the greatest. You can do it when they go for the link cross play. It doesn't do the most because they have, like, Faker in hand, Manifestation set, but it's still a time to use it. He's targeting the Imperm. Gets Afterburners, and this is what I was saying last turn, where he should have grabbed Afterburners, because now it was like, he pretty much shouldn't have gotten, like, a way to ray off of that. Like, it was a gamble. You shouldn't be playing like it is a gamble. Doesn't do it. Oh, okay. This guy obviously didn't play Striker back in the day. Because you could Afterburners pop Mel, you see, pop Area Zero, bring out Ray, get your engine started. And then you have Widow Anchors. Yeah, you definitely beat your opponent there if you do that. I guess he's playing around like Ash maybe, but it'd be Chain Link 1 Area 0, and if he wants to Ash, that means he's not using Melu Seek effect. First of all, imagine Faker going into 3 just for you to brick on it. That sucks. Battle phase tech for 500. He's really not going to Widow Anchor take that. That is so interesting. Yeah, he's gonna normal out Faker. Link those two away for Hextia. Melu Seek effect, add Marionetter. Then gets rid of Hextia for Linkross. Uses both of the effects, so he's going to bring out tokens and add protocol. And this is what I was saying, like, Nib is good against this play because now he's summoned 5 times. Set proto, pass. I'm very surprised he didn't drop Nib, just so that way Area Zero can get rid of it. He was playing as if Afterburners isn't a starter for him anyways. So, I don't know. Desires, banish 10. Draws Area Zero, Imperm. So he's out of Ray. If he's only playing 2 rows, then he's out of rows also. Hold on, did he banish Hornet? He didn't banish Hornet, so there's still a Hornet in there. People really need to learn how to play Striker, because he had a way to Ray turns ago, like 3 turns ago, and he decided to just not go for it. Area Zero, get him Hornet. Some people just don't even see that line of play. Activate Hornet, bring out a token. On-res protocol, this is obvious. Bring out Faker, Silk Bounce the token. Then, yep, Striker's gonna admit defeat there. After messing up, like, multiple turns in a row, he threw the game. Like, he can't really be mad at that. The open hand is Extravagance, Imperm, Meluseek, Imperm, Faker, so that's a good hand. Then he opened up Hornet, Shark, Veiler, Ash, Rota. Also, I'm thinking about just showing my Geist list off. Like, it's going to be once I get the new PC, obviously, so that way the video is not super laggy. And he's playing 41. All right. That needs to go down the 40 ASAP. But I'm thinking about showing my Geist list off once I get the new PC. And I'm going to make the How to Hand Trap Eldritch video once I get the PC. And How to Hand Trap Adamant Scepter once I get the new PC. Just those aren't going to be in replays. Those are going to be like on DB where it's more laggy for this PC. And it will literally skip so much you guys won't be able to watch the video. So it's not that I'm being lazy about it. It's that I want to put out good content for you guys, not some shit content. But my Geist list is like way different than most people. I'm playing 14 hand traps in my main deck. Because I feel like if you don't draw hand traps, this deck just loses to like a Savage. Or literally just like the simplest of things. Ash on Extravagance, pass. That good thing he passed, because Imperm you can just use from hand. Some people would like set one Imperm there to like bluff their opponent, but you really don't need to. That just plays into like Cosmic and Twin. More people have been playing Twin than ever, I swear. I've been getting Twin game 1 while playing Geist. That's why I stopped grinding with Geist. He draws Widow and Afterburners. Rota. Add Ray. Normal out Ray. Link Ray away. Kind of interesting that he didn't just tag with 15 and then tag out in the Hayate. I mean, he's playing around like, I don't even know, because Gamma would have got hit on Ash. Yeah, I don't know what he's playing around by doing that. Send jamming waves, but I have seen more people also not attacking with Ray and then tagging out in Hayate. I don't know what kind of PTSD they have, but you ain't gotta do that. Makes Kagari to add back jamming. Gets hit with Imperm. What do you banish off of this? Alright, I was gonna say, I feel like you would just grab multi-roll just to, like, out-advantage your opponent quickly. Because you're playing a deck like Geist. Imperm, Kagari, drop Faker. Faker gets hit with Widow. Gets rid of Kagari for Shiz. He was just going to bring Melusic off of that anyhow. It's not going to be the end of the world. Set Hornet, Set Shark. End phase, Shizad. He does have 4 spells in grave. It's pretty big that he doesn't have 5 right now. Because Melusic can still attack and do damage. Adds Widow at end phase. Wait. Yeah. You definitely can't add Widow end phase. Oh! Come on! How do people not catch this? It's like back in the day, people would try Shiz at engage, but they'd have like 2 engage in grave. And Trickstar, Sky Striker. It's just embarrassing. But I mean, like, this is like both their faults. Neither of them caught it. It doesn't say just add a Sky Striker spell. Draws Melusic. Not a good draw since he already has one. Normal summon Melusic. But let's pretend he added something else. What would have actually been like the right thing to add there? Can't add multi-roll. It's already gone. That's Hornet Sub. Has Shark. Went through his jammings. Has Afterburners. Maybe just Area Zero. Yeah, that might be one of the only cards you can even search. Battle Phase. Attacks with Melusic. I think he should activate Hornet Drones on this attack. He summons it out. It has 1500 defense. So, like, neither of these can attack over it. And then, also, it puts 5 spells in grave, so a Melusic can't send. And then, next turn, having multiple monsters and Striker doesn't really matter too much anymore. You could go into Zeki, bait stuff out, Kagari. You can do a lot. And then he wouldn't have lost Shark Cannon there. Link into Hextia. Also, I feel like this should be over here. Just putting stuff in the extra monster zone versus Striker. Like, they can get Rose in grave and then Afterburners you. And it can just lead to them end up getting an extra summon for no reason. Melusic at Faker. Link away Hextia into Link Cross. Same thing with this. It should just be over here. And then he's going to use the effects. Add Manifestation. Bring out tokens. And this combo is very good. Ends up with him having Multi-Faker and Manifestation. Which is his entire engine. Right there. Passes. He draws Veiler. Also, I'm doing something different with this deck than a lot of people. I'm playing less Geist monsters than most, or less Geist cards altogether than most. Like, I play 1 Manifestation, 1 Protocol, that's it for the traps. You don't need more. They're not good to draw going first or second in reality. You don't want to draw them. But you have to have one of each in the deck. And then also, Marionetter, it's not a starter, it sets Protocol, which isn't enough. So I cut down on that too. Makes Kagari effect, targets Shark Cannon. If he imperms, it also, like, forces Hornet, or makes him have to hold it. He's gonna chain Manifestation, bring out Hextia. Then he's gonna drop Faker. And then Faker effect, chain Widow, I mean... That doesn't do much because he's just going to chain Hex to you in the gate. And then he still brings out Silk. And this isn't once per turn in the gate. It's only once per turn add when it's sent from field to grave. He's going to normal out Veiler. Link in the Needle. Uses Needle Fiber effect. Gets hit with Imperm. Chains Hornet. He's thinking on res. He's gonna let it go. Man, this Striker player is doing it, like, the wrong way. I feel like you do Striker plays, then Synchro plays. Not Synchro, then Striker. Needle attack over for 600. Yeah, this is just gotta be wrong. Like, this is... I know this is wrong. Imagine, you could use, like, Needle Fiber and, like, Hayate, since they're machines, to go into the Mecham Phantom Beast and do combo from there. Imagine Striker actually doing, like, a legit, like, first turn end board. Draws Marionetter. I know it wouldn't be good. I'm just playing. Normal Summon Marionetter effect. Set Proto. But I'm not kidding about playing the Mecham Phantom Beast Link in my Altergeist deck. I actually do that. And it's nuts. He's gonna make Link Karibo. But also, I know someone's gonna say this. Oh, the Link Cross tokens can't be used as a Link Summon. Ah la la da da. For the rest of this turn. It's a different turn. Marionetter effect on Self and Seek. Switch Silk to attack. Goes into battle. Attacks direct. Uses the effect to send Shark. Hex the attack over the token. Token does have 1500. Gets rid of Link Rebo and token. Goes into Phoenix. Phoenix to pop the other set. Uses Silk effect. Bounce Needle. And then Hextia goes to Grave. He gets Hextia effect. Adds Konkiri. Now he has Proto Manifestation. Silk on board. Konkiri ready to pop off. Set Manifestation pass. Draws Imperm. He's probably just going to scoop. Yeah, he's going to say he has nothing. He played that pretty bad. I'm not going to lie. A lot of Striker players don't really know how to play new Striker. I'm not gonna lie, it's not the same as old Striker at all. Some of it is, but most of it isn't. Like, when you go for a game, like, when to know to go for a game, that's a huge thing. Holding your cards, sending the right stuff, adding the right stuff. You pretty much, like, have to play perfect or near perfect to actually win with this deck against, like, a grindy matchup like this. But, I don't know. I can't wait to show you guys my Geist list, though. I feel like a lot of people on my channel are going to be like, oh, your list is so bad. It doesn't look like this guy's list. Well, good, because that guy's list is ass. Whoever you're talking about, future you, that guy's list is ass. But, yeah, I don't know. I feel like Altergeist needs, like, a lot of hand traps. I mean, they can't break a board. Like, the guy that, I can't remember his name. But he won the event with Geist during Spiral format. I just watched, like, one of his videos yesterday playing against Ryan. Oh, Pack. That's his name, Pack. Like, his list should not have won that event. There's no way his list won that event. He played 6 hand traps in a format he played 9 maybe? 6 or 9? I don't know. You have to play in a format that was spiral combo based with a trap deck. It doesn't make sense that he won. Shout out to him though. No hate towards him. But I think, yeah, I don't know. I think these lists should definitely be built different. Like, trap cards are just not good. You do have to play a few trap cards just because, you know, Faker requires a trap card. But I don't think you should be playing a lot of trap cards because trap cards just suck. It's like, why are you actually playing 2 protocol? Do you actually want to draw this card? No. If it gets sent to graveyard, you can grab it back with Silk. You can grab it back with Manifestation. You can grab it back with Prime Banshee. Wherever it is, you can grab it back with that. There's just so many different ways to get it back. You don't need more. Unless if it gets Cosmic, that sucks. But, I mean, if it gets Cosmic, oh well. Like, you're not going to play 2 just because of Cosmic. Cosmic isn't that popular of a card in the main deck. But, that's it for the video. Like, comment, and subscribe. The Hand Trapping the Meta Decks video will be out next week. My Geist list will be out next week. Me playing Geist will be out next week. I'm probably going to start streaming next week. I'm not going to completely confirm that. But I'm going to try live streaming. If I like it, I'm going to continue to do it. If I don't, then it's probably just going to be like a one and done type thing. But that's it for the video. Like, comment, subscribe. The DB Grand just signing off. Peace.